Hi. Let's open it from here. And let's open it from here. Oh, so quickly. What happened? Why it is difference? Why I can't open so easily from here and it is so easy from here? Let's see that. Now I'll try to open this screw from my hand. Can we do that? We can't even turn. But with this, let's see that. With the hand, can't even turn, but this, it's so easy. So why it is like that? Hello friends, I hope all of you are keeping well, and as you have seen in the beginning that I was trying to open a door from two places, near the hinge and from the side, and then I was trying to unscrew a screw with my hand and with the screwdriver. So you might have got an idea that this video is about what? What? It is about turning effect or moment, which is a very, very important topic of physics, and it starts from class 8 to 12. So I'm going to give you a basic idea along with some questions from moment topic. So welcome to your very own channel, sonisinghphysics. Now I'll tell you what is effort, moment and pivot. Effort is the force that you put in to move the load. Moment is the turning effect of a force which is measured in Newton meters, and pivot is the point about which the force turns. So these are the terms which we use in calculation of moment of a force. Formula to calculate moment is force into force arm. Then what is force arm? Force arm is a perpendicular distance from point of action or pivot. In the case of door, this hinge is the point of action or pivot, because along this point only this object moves. So the point along which the object moves, that is called point of action. Now we are going to calculate moment when we apply a force from here and when we apply a force from here. You can assume that I am applying a 50 Newton force either from this place or that place. Now we'll see why it is easy from here, what changes happen in the turning effect. I'll tell you the unit for turning effect is Newton meter, because its formula is force into distance or force into force arm. Unit of force is Newton and unit of distance is meter. So it is Newton meter. Now we'll see that. For example, if this distance is 0.1 meter and I am applying 50 Newton force from here, so turning effect along this point will be 50 into 0.1 meter, that is 5 Newton meter. So I can just apply 5 Newton meter turning effect if I am using this point. But suppose I am using this point, this handle, then this distance is 1 meter. So the turning effect will be 50 Newton into 1, so it is 50 Newton meter. So you can see that I am the same person, but I just changed the point from where I am applying the force, and because of that it becomes more turning effect. So turning effect or moment depends upon two factors: force and distance from the fulcrum. So if you increase the distance from the fulcrum, the turning effect will increase, and if you increase the force without changing the distance, then also turning effect will increase. So these are the two factors, force and distance from the fulcrum, on which it depends. The same thing happened in case of screw also. When I'm using my hand to unscrew it, what happened? There is almost negligible force arm. So the moment will also be almost negligible. But once I'm using the screwdriver, then this is the force arm. So this will give a very greater turning effect rather than using my hand just near the point. Turning effect can be possible in two ways, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. To understand that, just hold a scale in your hand, and if I am holding like this, then this is having tendency to go this side and this is having tendency to come this side. So the force which is towards your right hand will produce clockwise moment, and the force which is towards your left hand will produce anti-clockwise moment. If two moments are acting on opposite sides of a pivot, we can calculate whether they are balanced or not. One moment is described as anti-clockwise because it turns around the pivot in the anti-clockwise direction. The other moment is the clockwise moment because it turns around the pivot in the clockwise direction. Zida and Zane sit on opposite sides of a seesaw. Zane weighs more than Zida. Zane realizes that since he weighs more, to balance Zida, he must sit closer to the pivot. This is because moment is equal to weight into distance from the pivot. So if you want to keep the moment same, for a bigger force, you have to decrease the distance from the pivot. Friends, I hope this video will be helpful for you. Please like, share and subscribe to your very own channel, Sony Singh Physics, your simple physics teacher. Thank you. Thanks for watching.